Welcome to IFBRI. I'm Joachim von Braun. I would like to welcome you. Exciting times, important times, especially for poor people. The high food prices have kept many of you and us at IFBRI on our toes on behalf of poor people. I would like to briefly introduce and then ask my colleagues to specifically speak to the action proposals which IFBRI has put together, and we want to discuss those with you. Ladies and gentlemen, a combination of new and ongoing forces is driving the world food situation from the demand and the supply side, and in turn, the prices of food commodities. So it cannot be just one issue. Prices are always driven from two sides. Rising energy prices and subsidized biofuel production, income growth, and population growth are among the major forces contributing to the surging demand. On the supply side, it is the underinvestment in agricultural innovation and growing land and water constraints, and the lack of access to productive inputs, and then triggered by weather disruptions, which have impacted on the prices. The last effect, the triggering of disruptions from the weather side, from the weather fronts, is not just a short-term phenomenon, but many of us believe it's foreshadowing what climate change will bring us. The food price crisis hits the world that has the most unequal income distribution ever. So, talking euphemistically about a food price crisis raises the issue, whose crisis is that? Who is in crisis? It's a poverty crisis. And the inequality issues, the fact that the poorest of the poor have been left behind more in the last 15 years, as documented by IFBRI's 2020 Vision Initiative, I think is a very important aspect of what makes the price crisis a people crisis. Progress towards achieving the poverty and hunger Millennium Development Goal is compromised for some time to come. The complex causes of the food and agriculture crisis require comprehensive response of equal complexity. Otherwise, it won't work. In view of the urgency of assisting people and countries in need, we at IFBRI suggest two sets of policy actions, an emergency package of four actions to take immediately, and a resilience package of four actions to phase in now, but whose impact may take time. The emergency package comprises of the following four actions: expand humanitarian assistance, eliminate agricultural export bans, undertake fast impact food production programs in key areas, and change the biofuel policies. The resilience package, as we call it, comprises of the following four actions. It's item 5, calm the markets; number 6, invest in social protection; and number 7, scale up investment for sustained agricultural growth; and number 8, complete the WTO Doha round successfully. Not just complete it successfully. I will now call on Mark Rosegrund to focus on the production and productivity issues and elaborate on those sets of actions, including, by the way, the biofuels contentious issues. And thereafter, I will ask Maximo Torero to discuss the markets and trade issues, the calm the markets approaches. And last not least, John Hodinot, Deputy Division Director from the Food Consumption and Nutrition Division, to address the emergency and social protection issues. As I said, Mark Rosegrant is the Division Director of the Environment and Production Technology Division. Mark very much leads the efforts of the in the model family of the IFPI impact model, which, by the way, gave us the early warning signals about 3 years ago, which we published, that something is about to go terribly wrong with the world food system. The degree of listening was selective. Actually, it was interesting to note that the repeated call for attention to the lack of attention on the supply and productivity side and the fast growth in demand widening the gap of supply and demand and potentially driving prices, at least derived from Marx's models, into extreme increases. That listening came first from the developing world. But the rest of the world caught up very quickly. Today, we have a lot of action proposals on the table. We're happy to say that the IFPI action proposals have been listened to very carefully. We want to see the scope for this afternoon's discussion with you to really refine our messages with your help and to critically review them for their implementation capabilities. I believe we pretty well know by now what triggered the crisis, what caused it to build up. I think we also pretty well know what to do in broad terms. But what, where, how, in what sequence, I think, and at what scale, those are now the tricky issues.